Hey everyone, Abbi from Abbi Kirsten Collections here, and today we're going to be making these really cute and easy cake toppers with the help of our Cricut machine.
Well, hey there my friends, today we're going to be making these really cute and simple cake toppers with your Cricut machine. So we're going to be visiting how to use offsets in Cricut Design Space to create this cake topper effect where we sort of layered our paper. And I'm going to kind of show you a floating cake topper approach, but you absolutely don't have to go this way. You could sort of use bamboo skewers and just make it a traditional cake topper as well. But let's go over the supplies you're going to need for this project. So first you're going to need a Cricut machine. I'm using the Cricut Maker 3 here, but you can use the Explorer 2, the Explorer 3, the Maker, the full size machines, all those are going to work. You can use the Joy as well, but the Joy typically works best with medium weight cardstocks. You can give it a try with the glitter and the foil, glitter cardstocks and the foil cardstocks, but you may need to up your pressure or change the settings a little bit to get that to work on the Joy. You'll need to have a Cricut mat to cut your materials out on. So I recommend the light blue grip mat or the standard green mat that I'll be using here. For our actual materials here, I am using the Cricut brand glitter cardstock and the Cricut brand foil poster board here, and we're going to be layering those together. I'm also using some clear acetate. This is 4 mL acetate. I'll link my resources below for you. If you want to create sort of an additional clear offset here, and I'll show you kind of the purpose of why I do that as we walk through the tutorial. For our adhesives, I'm using this Barely Art Precision Craft Glue, which works really well for layering paper crafts. And I'll also be using a hot glue gun when it comes to attaching our picks for our cake topper to sit inside of our cake. For our picks, I am using these little floral card picks. So these are like the things that people stick in bouquets and they put the little thank you card or the note on it. So I'm using these and I'm gonna show you two different ways to use them. I'll link my resources for this as well. But these are really handy for cake toppers because they work really well. You may need to have a pair of scissors on hand as well. And that's about it. Let's go ahead and get started with this craft.
All right, so I just want to show you a quick look here at how I would create offsets for my cake toppers. So this image here is from Cricut Access, so you can find it in their images. If we take a look here, the exact image info is this number right here. So you're welcome to copy that from the screen share here in order to view this exact happy birthday if you would like to follow along with it. The first thing I'm going to do is scale this to the size that I want. Now we are going to be adding an offset around this, so it is going to expand the size a little bit. So if you're aiming for like a 7.5 inch cake topper, then I'd start not much higher than 6.5 inches, okay? And that's what I'm kind of aiming for here. So that's where I'm going to start for now. And then we're going to go up to the offset button that's at our top, sort of to the left a little bit. And it's gonna default to, right now it's a 0.25. And if you give it a second, it'll show you kind of a preview here. I'm gonna take this down just a smidge here. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and hit apply. And it's gonna look like this. So it's gonna give us sort of this black background here. And we can change this to any color. So in my case, I'm gonna actually make it pink. There we go, okay. Now what I want to do is I want to get rid of these little weird cutouts here that the offset left behind. So I'm going to click on the pink offset here in my case, and I'm going to click on the contour button down at the bottom of the layers panel to our right. And it's going to bring up a new sort of panel that looks like this. Just click on the hide all contours option and then close it out. And now those little awkward cutouts are gone. If you want to leave them, that's fine, but I prefer to get rid of them. Okay, so one offset is done there. We could stop right here and go ahead and just cut this out. In my tutorial, you're going to see me add a second offset because I like to do an additional offset that's going to be in clear acetate because it kind of gives a little bit more of a floating cake topper look when you're able to connect those clear picks more directly to the acetate, which is clear, rather than directly into the cardstock or the glitter cardstock. It just kind of enhances the floating cake topper look, but it's entirely optional. If you wanted to do a different color, maybe you have three different colors in mind you want to use, then you could do that as well. So I'm going to click on the pink offset here and then click on the offset tool again. And this time I'm going to up it to 0.35. and it's going to expand quite a bit there. So I'm going to hit apply, and this is going to be in clear, so I'm just going to change it to white there for my example. Don't forget to save your projects, that way you can always come back to them to remake them and you don't have to go through all of this setup process. I'm going to click on the make it button at the top so that we can go to our cut screen now. This is our first cut screen here. There's nothing we have to do on this screen, so I'm just going to click on continue. It's going to connect to my Cricut machine. I'm using the Maker 3, but you can use the Explore models, the full-size machines, all those are going to work just fine. So this first one here, I am doing an acetate in that. So there is an acetate setting. You can browse in Cricut Design Space here by searching under the materials. For this, this mat here, I am going to be doing the foil. So I would search for the foil poster board, which is the setting here. And then for this pink mat here, I will be doing glitter cardstock. So I would select glitter cardstock for that. And we will go ahead and load our mat up here. Okay, let's go ahead and load up our Cricut machine.
All right, so I'm getting started with my glitter cardstock here. We're gonna place that down. You may wanna use your brayer tool to push the material to the mat. If your mat's well used, this can be very helpful. And we're gonna go ahead and load this up. I've selected glitter cardstock in Cricut Design Space, and I'm gonna press the double arrow flashing button to load my Cricut machine. Cricut is going to measure the mat really quickly, and once it's done with that, it's gonna flash this play icon button, or it might look like a Cricut icon button. This is essentially the go button that will proceed, will tell Cricut to proceed with the cut. All right, so the cut's done. We're gonna press the double arrow flashing button to unload our mat. Go ahead and flip your mat over and peel the mat away from your material. That way you don't curl your paper here. Just like that. And here is our cutout piece. There we go. So that's our first piece done. I'm gonna go ahead and get the foil poster board next. So the foil poster board, this is by Cricut. Again, this is one of their materials. I really like their foil poster board. It's very sturdy and it comes in a lot of pretty colors. I'm gonna go ahead and load this onto my mat here. Okay, so I'm gonna unload my mat for this as well, same way. All right, so this part is optional, but I am gonna be adding a layer of acetate to the base, and it's gonna create more of a floating cake topper effect when we're done with it. But like I said, totally optional, you don't have to do this stuff at all. There is an acetate setting in Cricut Design Space you can use, so you'll just search that under materials. All right, so now it's time to assemble. I'm gonna start with this delicate overlay piece here, and we're gonna be adding this on top of our pink. So I'm gonna go ahead and flip this over. I'm using my Barely Art Precision Glue here, and I'm just gonna go around and add a little bit of glue all around the back there. All right, so that is done. We're gonna go ahead and add it onto this piece here. Once you get the initial piece down, you may want to let it dry for like maybe 5 minutes. You might want to set something like a book on top of it just to get all those little edges to stay nice and flat as that glue is setting up. Usually a good 5 minutes will get it to really grab, and then you can move on to the next step. Like to add on the clear acetate so that it creates a little extra buffer to create that floating effect when we add our clear sticks. You would do it the same way we just did this. You just flip it over and add some glue and then glue it to the acetate. So I'll just go around the edges here just like that. Here I want to give it just a minute to set up. While that sets up, I want to talk to you about these little floral picks here. So these are like the things that you would stick in a bouquet and it has a little greeting card on the top of it. So there's two ways I like to use these. One is to cut them in half right here and use just the top part here with the little prongs. The second way I like to use them is to cut them in half and use this little flat area with hot glue and glue that to the backside of our cake topper. So for example, with my Hooray cake topper here, I cut this right before that little flat piece there, and I glued with hot glue right on the back side behind the lettering so you couldn't see it. And now it kind of looks like it's floating for our cake topper. So you can do either, or you could even leave it whole if you wanted like an extra long one. I usually find that cutting them is perfectly fine, and it's pretty fragile plastic, so a pair of scissors does the job. Just line up where you want and be careful, and give it a quick snap and it'll pop apart there for you. And now you can use either one of these pieces for your cake topper. So it's really your choice. So for something like this one, I didn't add the acetate to it. I could place this on, but I think for me it'd make more sense to use this option. So I'm gonna cut another one of these real quick. I'll show you both ways here. Okay, so for this part, if I'm doing the flat edge, I would decide where I'm going to place these. For me, I think I'm gonna put it under the S and right under the O. Make sure you're keeping the ends even there, because you don't want your cake topper to like end up being lopsided. So once I've decided where I'm gonna place those, then I'll get my hot glue gun and I'll go ahead and load it up with a bit of hot glue right there on that flat edge. And I'll place that where I had decided. And then you're gonna repeat the process on the other side. All right, so there's how I could use those picks one way, and this still kind of looks like a floating cake topper as well. And then the other way we could use them is without any glue at all, we could just take our floral picks here and slide this right on. Just like that, and you're good to go. That's how easy it is. And it just sits right on there. So you can do it either way. You could even use a bamboo skewer if you want to. This is how I would make really quick and easy and cute cake toppers with my Cricut machine. I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial, and if you have other questions, please let me know. I'd be happy to answer them for you. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.